ćwierk nadający się.
Spruce for resonating woodblocks must grow high in the mountains so that growth rings are as small as possible due to harsh conditions. Chances are that when felled, this piece of wood will yield a lot of resonating material.
Tu jest fantastyczny kawałek.
Here is a great piece.
Bardzo rzadko się zdarza.
It is very uncommon that these growth rings run so fine all the way around the core.
Ten klocek można.
This block can be cut into wood blocks all around.
Takie drzewo powinno być ścięte w czasie.
Such a tree should be felled when the sap is already gone, which means somewhere between November and February. After felling, it has to be cut pretty soon, at first into quarters and in a few months into woodblocks, which then have to be seasoned for at least 10 years, on the northern side and well ventilated.
O, to już jest jawor, który.
Yeah, this maple tree is large enough to be cut into wood blocks from which backs are made.
Aby pociąć z tego tak zwane klepki na płyty spodnie, przy czym do końca nie wiemy,
czy. As a matter of fact, we don't know for sure if it has those characteristic folds under the bark. Here one can see the swellings only in the bottom part. These folds would have to show up below the line of boughs and branches.
W którym zaczynają się już konary, gałęzie, to ten jawor już by się.
Then this maple tree would be good enough for instruments.
Ja jestem po takiej rozmowie dłuższej 5 lat temu z Giobatą Rossi.
5 years ago, I had a lengthy conversation with Giobata Morassi. He's a guru, a Cremona legend.
Jak on szuka drzewa.
All those stories, how he looked for alpine wood, what weather it took, what moon, whether new moon or some other phase. What humidity. And that's even before felling the tree.
Drzewa z, w postaci pnia. Ile to lat musi.
How many years it has to be seasoned?
Ile to musi być.
How many different kinds of varnish?
To kwestia duszy.
The question of soul is a very intricate notion. Naturally, the peg, the sound post, which is known in Polish as the soul, does have some importance, but I believe it is a very complex mixture of various factors which influence the sound of a violin. I am a very sentimental man, and when I enter a violin making workshop, deep down I feel the touch of the Almighty's hand. I treat it as if I entered a shrine. Ladies and gentlemen, my master and mentor, the great Tadeusz Wroński, used to say, the violin is one of very few instruments that have a soul. It does indeed, for it is with this instrument that we are able, perhaps imitating the human voice to a certain degree, to best render all states of human emotion. crying, laughing, singing. It is sometimes truly extraordinary. The very existence of the violin is a phenomenon in its own right.
Musi być taki drobny prześwit.
There has to be a tiny gap right in the middle when we press.
Takie klepki kleje się klejem ze skór.
Such wood blocks are glued with glue made of hide and bone, mainly bovine, just like 500 years ago. Nobody has yet come up with anything better.
Nadaje się też.
It is also the leporin glue that is good for the purpose. It is even stronger. The glue must not be too thick nor too watery. If it is too watery, it will simply not bond. If it is too thick, its layer will be too thick, while the whole thing boils down to doing it in such a way as not to show gluing marks.
To po prostu ma tego nie być widać, że tam cokolwiek się stało. Jeżeli jest dobrze sklejone, w przypadku świerku,
if it is done well, with spruce, for example, after a while it is difficult to find gluing marks.
Miejsce klejenia. No i
and that's what it's all about.
Violin making is more than 400 years old, and for the last 300 years, we've all been copying instruments that were made in the first 100 years, including Stradivari, who was copying the Amatis, and including Guarneri, who was also copying the Amatis. Basically, what I'm looking for is what kind of quality they have in relation to those instruments that were made 400 years ago. To create a good instrument, you also need a certain obsession. That's the first thing. The second thing is that violin making has, in general, improved and improved and improved over the last 50 years in particular. Polish makers are no further behind than anyone else. They're in the forefront. At some point, we will get as good as Stradivari and the Amatis and Guarneri. That doesn't mean that these instruments will be as valuable. It means that we can give these instruments, as many of us do already. I have instruments in the Berlin Philharmonic, and the concertmaster of the New York Philharmonic plays on one of my instruments. That doesn't make them Stradivaris. Stradivaris are still Stradivaris, and if I had the money, I'd buy a Stradivari.
Włochy najprawdopodobniej nie były.
In all probability, Italy was not the first, or at least not the only place where the violin originated, where it was built for the first time in the classical form as we know it today. It may have also happened in Poland. In the inventory made in 1602, after the death of Mateusz Dobrucki, who had inherited the workshop from his father, Jan de Dobruska, some 40 unfinished violins, 40 heads, and close to 200 soundboards were taken down. Unfortunately, no violins made by Mateusz Dobrucki have survived. In our collection, we have an instrument made in 1550, one of the first violins by Andrea Amati, who is considered the father of Italian or even world violin making. We also have an instrument made in the year 1600 by Marcin Groblicz I, who was almost Amati's peer. It is the oldest Polish violin still in use. Basically, it does not differ from the violin canon already in place in Italy. And then 1602, Balthazar Dankwart, Vilnius. It was the violin that was marked zero, that is, the model instrument in terms of sound during auditions of contemporary instruments in the competition.
Dobieramy materiał w ten sposób.
We combine material in such a way that, say, if we find maple, which is not particularly hard, it should not go together with highly resilient spruce.
To już jest pierwszy etap.
It is already the first stage, a very important one, that can influence the sound in the future.
Na dźwięku.
When I choose a piece of wood, there is certainly music because a piece of wood rings already. So I will choose a piece of wood which has a good structure, so it will act as a spring and will be light, so it doesn't absorb energy. And that's the first criterion, is really to have an acoustical wood with many acoustical properties. And of course, if it looks nice, then it will make a very nice violin. Making a violin is many aspects. We build our craft on a lot of technique, a lot of knowledge, and the more we have a structure for our work, the more we can relax and let the inspiration of the moment.
Like a child, every instrument starts with a dream, and working towards that dream is sometimes a surprise at the end. And also, like a child, there's some disappointment. And sometimes you only see an instrument after you haven't seen it for some time, so that the veil is lifted from your assumptions of what it's going to be to seeing it as something with a soul. But it takes time. When they're first created, I have a tendency to not be as happy because the dream didn't live up to its reality.
Here, in these wood lines, I can see that the flame should point downwards. In general, I prefer Stradivarius models, and it is him who has always inspired me. I have never been very keen on Guarneri, in particular Guarneri del Jesus model. Perhaps I don't understand it.
Mnie się po prostu nie podoba, poza może.
I simply don't like it, except perhaps for those beautiful soaring F-holes, which, in my opinion, do not go together with the shape of the body.
W Guarnerim.
The form of the instrument, its shape, the way it is arched. I like some of them and don't like others. And where is the borderline one must not trespass in order not to affect the sound? It's like with classical music. There's a musical piece written by a composer, and now the conductor has to do something with it. And he has about this much freedom. The piece must remain true to itself, But one way or another, the conductor has to carry out his original idea.
I search for some kind of individuality and something that actually pleases your eye. When you look at 100 instruments, some are just more sympathetic, some are less, some are cold, some are... some you would like to keep. They are very personal, they are like human.
To jest żyłka.
This is purfling, whose task is to protect wood from cracking. Besides, it is a decoration. The way purfling is mounted already shows you the maker's skill. It is very difficult and precise work. You carve a groove with a knife, some 4 millimeters from the edge, and glue purfling in the groove. Purfling is made of 3 pieces. Most often it is maple in the middle with ebony shavings on the outside, on both sides. It has to be nicely joined with the so-called bee stings, and one has to do his best to make the bee stings more or less identical. If you play an old Italian instrument, you know who made it, who played it, you already know something about it. Here you know nothing. It is the mystery, and this makes the whole process very intriguing. What is it that I'm looking for in this violin? I'm looking for a better violin. I want each instrument to be better than the previous one. The best violin I have played here already had a tonal quality very close to very good Italian instruments. After all, what is the best violin? Everybody will say that it is Italian, old, Stradivari, for example, or Guarneri del Gesù. It is such a clear sound. It is a sound that is very palpable, as if you could touch it with your hands. There is such an instrument which produces such a material sound. As far as the arching goes, at a given moment, the chisel simply goes as if by itself, and imagination suggests how to do it.
Wyobraźnia podpowiada, jak to należy zrobić, i tego się jakoś tam.
You can't say it has to be made like this and not some other way.
Tak i tylko tak, a nie inaczej.
Although violin makers use various shapes, major deviations from Stradivari classics do not work.
Nie zdają egzaminu. Jakobus Steiner, niemiecki lutnik, stosował bardzo wysokie sklepienia.
Jakobus Steiner, a German violin maker, used very high arching. These instruments were very loud, and there was a time when these were Steiner's instruments that sold better. They fetched better prices than Stradivari's violins.
W momencie, kiedy muzyka na skrzypcach przeniosła się do dużych sal,
When violin music moved to large halls, it was observed that those highly arched, loud instruments were indeed loud, but in chamber hall conditions. Those with lower arching had greater range.
There are many modern instruments that will sound in the hall as good as a Stradivari. But it doesn't make them Stradivari. Stradivaris have something else. They have 200 years of wear. They are originals, and we are copyists. That's, I think, probably the answer. Sound-wise, I think musicians can afford to buy modern instruments, and they can use modern instruments without worrying about whether they're going to produce a sound, which was the case 50 years ago, 100 years ago. Modern instruments didn't quite have the edge of the old Italian instruments, but now that's changed. The big difference now is that those instruments are antiques, and they're very valuable antiques. The modern instrument is a working tool, if you like.
The first thing is the sound, the tone. Secondly, it is the ease with which the sound is produced. Certain instruments by Guarneri del Gesù are difficult to play, and often it takes days or even weeks from the moment you start playing on an instrument before you feel you are able to play it well. The best violins, Stradivarius, respond instantly. Ultimately, it is what sound you get, not how fast you get it, that matters. On each violin I play, I somehow express my soul. There have been numerous legends about the violin and the soul. For example, about Paganini. The sound of the violin expresses such strong emotions that it is no mean thing. It is a very profound thing that appeals right to our souls and our humanity.
Taki sposób opracowania grubości płyt.
Apparently, it was Antonio Stradivari who used this method of working the thickness of the backs and fronts. Another method, which I have been using recently, is more similar to this used by Niccolò Amati. It looks different depending on how hard, how resilient material we have. When we start work, basically on anything, the knife, the chisel, straight or round, you should simply be able to shave with them. Otherwise, there is no sense to even think about work. Maple is a rather hard wood, and one should work with decisive, confident movements. No way one can merely try to scratch it. With the belly, one can afford a somewhat thinner work. I usually start with 3.2 to 3.4 millimeters in the center and decrease it to 2.5 to 2.7 millimeters in the flanks. With this material, which is not particularly hard, I have worked the center somewhat thicker, 3.4 millimeters.
W policzkach
2.4 millimeters in the flanks, and in the lower parts a little thicker, 2.6 millimeters, because what we have here is a large surface.
When a maker becomes so confident with his own work that he can use the tools and use the materials freely and easily without having to think every step of the way, there's a stiffness in the first time you start making instruments which gradually disappears when you get the confidence to make instruments a little bit more freely. And I think that's the kind of thing we look for.
Opracowałem do tego modelu własny F, który
for this model, I have elaborated my own F hole, which I believe suits it best. In the past, I modeled one instrument on Niccolo Amati, I guess, and I used Guarneri's model once. In general, all my models have been inspired by Stradivari's. But I try not to fully imitate what can be copied from various drawings.
Uda się odrysować z różnego rodzaju rysunków. Czyli można powiedzieć,
so one can say that it is a Stradivari's F-hole, somewhat reworked by Słodyczka.
Hurra! Teraz czeka mnie długa i żmudna praca, żeby
what awaits me now is long and tedious work of final polishing the F-hole with a knife. It will take approximately 1.5 days to complete the job.
Będą gotowe.
Usually when you make a great instrument, you know when it's finished that it's going to be good in the concert hall. But there's nothing quite like listening to your instrument being played by a great player. Even when players just come to visit to pick an instrument up, I just love that moment when they first put the bow across an instrument. It's a bit like, I guess for a lot of men, it's the only time they get near anything like a birth, you know, so giving birth. You need to have that feeling of, whew, it's finally finished, and then listening to someone play. Having said that, the next violin is always going to be a better one.
Bo
kawałeczki to są po prostu przygotowane listy.
The ribs are simply little linings of wood, some 1.2 mm thick.
Moczymy je i wyginamy.
We soak them in water and bend on a special hot tube.
Taki boczek składa się z sześciu.
Such a rib is made of six joint strips of wood.
Zastosowali płytę spodnią z jednego kawałka.
If we were to use a one piece back, it would be desirable to make the upper and lower bout of one piece too.
A najlepiej, żeby
and in the ideal world, upon assembly, this flame should form an extension of the flame we have at the back.
Po zmontowaniu fali, którą mamy na płycie spodniej. Pojedynczymi ściskami staramy się
using clamps we join the back plate with the ribs
spodnią z boczkami
and make sure that the edge is equally far from the ribs.
Dookoła było równo oddalona od tych boczków.
May I take a look, Kaja?
Zrobić ten pierwszy.
I will try to do the first corner, right?
Ja myślę, że ponieważ ty tutaj chcesz robić, żeby było wszystko delikatnie.
As you want to do it all in a delicate and soft way, I think this element should follow suit too. Do you know that there can be as many as 21 or even 22? When a violinist plays and gets to the position, he should feel a kind of resistance here. He should feel the neck and the fingerboard, feel that the thickness grows. Here you still have a lot to get rid of. My master, Franciszek Mardua, would say that you need an axe to remove it.
Staramy się przede wszystkim na pierwszym etapie.
In the first stage, we try above all to make sure that they master the skill. That is, that they feel at ease using tools. In the meantime, they get familiar with the stylistics of different European violin making schools. But there comes a time when they have to build an instrument according to their own idea, based on their own experience, own knowledge, which they acquire here at violin making history classes, as well as in the workshop. And practically speaking, it is visible in all elements, in running the outline, executing the arching, finishing the edges, forming the volute. There is a lot of magic in violin maker's work. For apart from having to master the skill, having to get familiar with the material, which is very important, he leaves a part of himself in the instrument he builds.
Zostawia tam w tym instrumencie cząstkę siebie.
Pierwszy był pradziadek, także pradziadek uczył się u.
The first was my great-grandfather, Franciszek, who studied with German masters. He taught his son Stanisław, who later educated two sons of his own. Then there was my father, Stefan, who taught my brother and me. And I have passed the trade on to my two sons. It is, I guess, a certain gift. Yet, as with any art, later on one has to find his own master and study hard. To this very day, I work with tools used by my great-grandfather. They were bought over 120 years ago and handed down from generation to generation. It is a source of joy and satisfaction. If somebody shows you a good way, it does not mean that there is no better one. Naturally, things at work are handed down, but it does not mean that somebody won't be able to find a new way of doing things. Take the setting of the bow, for example, the so-called rehairing. My father worked somewhat differently than I do. Making concert instruments, repairing instruments, I believe each generation basically found fulfillment. So this period of time has been well used. And what I find particularly satisfying is the continuity. The ability to hand all this down to somebody, combined with the feeling that the mission we had to perform has been fully accomplished.
Znawcy instrumentów, biorąc instrument do ręki,
taking an instrument into his hand, an expert first looks at the scroll and instantly knows whom he is dealing with. It is best if the scroll is made of the same trunk of which we make the back and ribs.
Trzeba opracować kształt.
One has to draw up the shape and make sure that there are no dead lines anywhere. Shapes abound. Even if I happen to sculpt something of this model, during the work I slightly change the distances of the turns of the volute, the size of the eye, walls for the peg box, and so on and so forth.
Ścianki, korytka i tak dalej, i tak dalej. Człowiek w każdym momencie jak gdyby widzi inaczej.
At every moment, man sees differently. As a matter of fact, the scroll is made at the end to stylistically match what we have made so far. That is, the body.
Czyli do gotowych już płyt. Ślimak jest w zasadzie ozdobą.
Essentially, the scroll is a decorative element. Female heads, monks' heads have been carved. Roblicz carved dragon heads. On one occasion I built a historical instrument, a 14-string viola d'amore, and decorated it with a puto's head.
Tam wyrzeźbiłem główkę amorka. To muzycy są hamulcem przy pewnych zapędach.
These are musicians who curb violin makers' inclinations to introduce changes. They start yelling, but Stradivari never did it like that. And the tradition is adhered to again.
Lakierowanie to jest zmora wszystkich.
Varnishing is the nightmare of all violin makers. And it is to varnishing that we devote most time in our research and experiments. Recently, I have used apparently one of the finest rosins from the southern coast of France.
Faktycznie jest coś takiego w tych starożytnych.
There is something in these old Italian instruments. Under the varnish, there is something that has not been fully examined yet. Some primer, some silicon compounds. Different legends are circulated what this might be. Even volcanic ash has been considered.
Nawet o jakimś zapuszczeniu pyłem wulkanicznym i tak dalej.
Indeed, it is one of the few unsolved mysteries.
Nieodgadnionych właśnie tajemnic. To tak się mówi, żeby wyszło.
It is said that to make a good instrument, one has to put his whole heart, his entire soul to its construction. One must not forget about the soundpost, or soul in Polish, and adequately place this peg, for the sound of the instrument heavily depends on its proper placement.
Zależy dźwięk instrumentu. Sądzę, że można już użyć takiego.
I believe one can already say that if there are Stradivaris, there are also Słodyczka's violins. They do possess some unique qualities, and there are violin makers who will recognize my work and my hand.
Rozpoznają moją robotę, moją rękę. To jest
takie dążenie
do striving for something that cannot be grasped.
Uchwycić nie można,
striving for some perfection which most probably does not exist.
Której pewnie nie ma, lutnicy.
Violin makers szukają, keep searching and then die and eventually never find it. I have set myself a goal of making sure the violin making competition is not overshadowed by the violin event, to show that as far as prestige and recognition are concerned, it is as important. I would like the violin of the best tonal qualities to dominate the score sheet. The name of the event is violin making competition, which means that it is a contest for makers. After all, however, they do not build instruments for the building's sake. They build them to have them produce beautiful sound in the concert hall. If we sit here and listen, we won't be able to spot the difference between supreme varnish and its less than perfect variety. What will be immensely important for the ear is the sound.